So here are all the outfits that I need in my life. But the question is, can you guess what I use them for? But the thing is, I wasn't always like this.
Yo, Kung Fu Panda's open.
PlayStation, YouTube, football, I was addicted to comfort. That was 5 years ago, but what changed? I read David Goggins. Okay, so this is my daily routine. 5:45, wake up, do YouTube work. I gotta finish that by 6:30 because it's time for actual work. Work from 7:30 to 5 p.m. and then an hour driving back home. Finally get home and do some training. And then from 7:30 to 9:30 is YouTube work. So I finish work at 9:30. I have my evening routine and then I go to bed. If you can't tell already, I really enjoy being productive. So what I've got here is just some tips that have really helped me become more productive since reading David Goggins. Okay, so the first tip that I want to talk about is time efficiency. Live your life like a 24-hour mission. So basically the opposite of this. I remember why I loved being on social media so much. The latest news on YouTube, the KSI and Ricegum beef. There's comfort in being up to date. I just think living your life is a 24-hour mission. Like, I remind myself of it because when I have that urge for the YouTube video or that Instagram post or that text message, it's that, okay, but in a mission, if you were on a mission right now, would you do that? The answer would be no. So why are you doing it? It's just, it's a frame of mind that I like. But what if you just couldn't be bothered? This is actually like the perfect timing because it's currently 10 to 2. I've just had my food and here I am procrastinating. So I'm gonna go to the accountability mirror quickly. It doesn't have to be a mirror, but think of it like a session where you just expose yourself. And you will know that someone out there has done the thing that you just haven't done. When you go back in the house today, food, cold shower, work. Just stop being a little and feeling sorry for yourself. People are working hard.
There's nothing.
People
are
sit here. People are working hard. Since when has it been okay to listen to your weak goddamn emotions? All the clips that you just watched there, they're all like times where I've had a long day in work, I've gotten home, and it's like, just had an hour session driving home, and then I'm going to the gym, and then I'm tired, and now I've got YouTube to do as well. It's like, it's those moments when you can't be bothered. It's time for the accountability mirror. Okay, so how do we balance our greatest dreams with our 9 to 5? Step one is time efficiency. Step two is the accountability mirror. And now step three leads me to this book here. So to give context, I'm 17, in college, working once a week. All my free time is going on the PlayStation, gaming and complaining that I don't have time. But then I read David Goggins. His daily routine was phenomenal. Waking up at 4 a.m, running a marathon to work and back. It blew my mind how useful a daily routine can be. And whilst I was in my bed reading David Goggins, it made me think, what the f*** am I doing with my life? What I needed was an efficient, productive routine. So that's what I did. So the plan is we wake up at 5:45, and our alarm goes off. We wake up, we do editing work, we go for our day, 6 p.m. we record. That seems pretty straightforward, right? Until you Don't wake up at 5:45, you miss your alarm, so you wake up at 6. YouTube editing is not done then. The YouTube editing gets pushed over you, the YouTube recording gets pushed over you. The point of this is to show that a routine can just make you so much more efficient with your life, but also it can hold you accountable, because if I snooze, there is a direct impact on the progression towards my goal in my life. And that right there is one of the best ways that's helped me stick to a good, productive routine. And the last point I want to talk about takes us to the Modern Wisdom podcast.
A reminder for the gladiators in the arena who feel beat up and scarred with no hope in sight. Building a business is hard. Hard feels shitty. This is what hard feels like.
This is what hard feels like. This is why people quit. It's just so nice to fall back onto. When it's a Wednesday at 6 p.m, you're driving home and there's traffic and it's raining outside and it's dark and you can't be bothered and you know you've got a training session and you know you've got YouTube to do when you get back home. It's that this is what hard feels like. It's just something nice to fall back on. And also on those tough days, I ask myself, what is the easiest thing I can do right now? Maybe it's bringing the tripod into the shed or setting up the mic for the video. It's the small things that are basically impossible to fail that help you achieve a much bigger goal. I'm a big believer in momentum, so bringing the tripod up, setting up my mic, the small habits build into something much bigger. But yeah, those have been my 4-5 tips on how I've become more productive in my life and how I am balancing the goal of YouTube with my job and as with uni and with gym and everything else. So I hope you enjoyed. I hope you got value. Always remember to become more, and I'll see you in the next episode. Take care.